2-0 this season in the skills competition.
Velarde looks like will be the first shooter for the Kings, so. And he has a lot of different things he can do. When it gets down to it, it's the quick hands normally for Gabe that gets it done.
Everybody ready. And the fans to their feet. Here we go.
Goes the other side this time.
And he misses.
So in Boston, he went left. This time he goes right. And right ends up being wrong. Just tried to get him to lean. He had a couple stick handles there.
Logan Couture is pretty good in the shootout in his career, 42%. Couture with speed misses the net.
You see that a lot. With Copley, he forces shooters to make the perfect shot. Similar situation there. The lean one way, shoot back against the flow. Kempe.
Kempe coming in wide to the middle. Stick save, Reimer.
He tried to do exactly what he did against the Bruins. He tried to go tweeners there. And this time Reimer has the fundamental down as far as stick between the pads. Probably not as accurate as the other night. But Eno, he's pretty tricky here.
39% in his career. Bonino closes in. Copley makes the stop.
You're looking to see if a goaltender flinches or budges. There's no deception there at all by Bonino. And Copley just, he keeps the blocker as big as possible.
Kevin Fiala 0 for 2 this season. Fiala scores!
Wow.
Boy, did he pick a spot.
And watch him change here. He gives a look when he gets about to the middle of the slot like he's going to shoot it. It's coming up right here. Oh, no, he doesn't. He just toe drags it. He doesn't shoot it. He toe drags it. That change, then very quickly, not allowing the goaltender to readjust.
LeBanc 1-for-4 this year. LeBanc flying into the zone, stops up. Deeks and scores 5-hole.
Change of speed is the issue here. And then patience. Because LeBanc goes quickly first, and watch right there. Flaps down. Bicycle kick. Right there. Open up. So you do get the goaltender to flinch. Previous, not the case.
That'd be something for Trevor Moore.
Let's talk
shootout out. Drama again. Into the fourth round. He scores!
Man, you just. His hands are just working so cleanly and so quick that it's tough to figure out that release of Trevor Moore. Last game, he went what we would call the short side, high glove. That time, he goes to the far side.
Trevor Moore's two shootout goals in his career have been deciders. A save wins the game for the Kings. Save, Copley! Kings win!
Huge two.
Early November, the Kings have won back-to-back games. A compelling, dramatic victory on home ice to get the 2 points.
And the skill does it. But Alex, let's hope we can continue this trend. The penalty kill for the Kings came up big at big moments. Tried to go five-hole, tried to go tweeners, and this time it's Copley with the fundamental stick between the pads on the ice. He gets it done. But the Kings, in an area they've struggled with all year, get the penalty kills when they need them, and that takes them to the 2 points.
Trevor Moore, signed, sealed, delivers again in the shootout. And the Kings win it 3-2. They'll exit the ice and will announce the three stars. Boy, this is so important. We talked about at the beginning of the day, so often the home team winds up being an underdog after a long road trip. San Jose came in rested. They hadn't played since Tuesday. They were coming off back-to-back victories. But the Kings had a huge lift. I wonder how big that win in Boston was to lift the team, confirm the things that they had done well to carry into tonight. Number three star is Jared Anderson-Dolan, who scored again against the Sharks.
What you like also, Alex, because the Kings did have that practice in Boston, and they worked on some things, and they took that practice right into the game. They really did. They made some adjustments. Again, it's mostly at the top of the penalty kill. But then just to sneak out two. Tonight was a well-played game, I think, by both teams. I think both coaches would kind of agree with that as far as not really glaring mistakes. You hang around, and for two games in a row, the Kings did not beat themselves. And you hang on, you get the two.
Timo Meier, the number two star. Mikey Anderson, the game's number one star.
I think quietly, Mikey Anderson has been real solid. Real solid, doing a lot of different things, denying entries, penalty kills, clearing pucks, doing the job.
It's been a big couple days for Trevor Moore. Big contract extension. He's standing by with Carl.
Thanks so much, Alex. Trevor, for you to get two back-to-back shootout deciding goals, how are you feeling right now, and how's this team doing after those two wins?
Pretty good. I think we played to our identity last couple games, which is huge. Good couple wins.
Well, you're a hometown kid, just signed a 5-year contract extension, first home game back in this building since doing so. You can hear the crowd giving you some love here. How much does that mean to you?
It's amazing. It's a dream come true. I appreciate everyone who supported me. Just super happy to be here.
How much does a win like this against a divisional opponent kind of lift the team up?
Huge. We're looking for consistency, and two good games like that, especially against a divisional team, that's given us a hard time in the past, so it's good.
All right, what do you guys need to carry over and bring into the next home game?
More of the same. I think it's been a good two games, and just keep rolling.
All right, keep up the great work. Congrats on the win.
Thanks, Ron.
Guys, back upstairs.
Well, a great start to the homestand. After a dramatic conclusion on the road, Trevor Moore. More shootout magic. Kings win 3-2. We'll be right back.